Hi, I'm Sina. I'm a senior engineering manager at Frame.io, and I'm excited to introduce our fully redesigned player and commenting experience in version 4. Two fundamental features of Frame.io, now more powerful and robust than ever before. Thanks to our new panel system, multitasking is a breeze. I can keep a pocket-sized version of the player pulled up while I browse through my assets in the grid. For a more focused viewing experience, I can enter the redesigned full-screen player, where I have access to the full suite of commenting, playback, and zoom controls. And regardless of whether I'm working with video, audio, images, or PDFs, these tools are pinned in the exact same spot in the bottom of the player, which minimizes visual distraction and lets the content shine. Under the hood, the version 4 player is more performant than ever, thanks to standardized HLS playback. That means you'll be able to play video content in Frame.io with a smoother viewing experience and fewer interruptions, regardless of your bandwidth. We've also added frame-accurate seeking to the player, which helps you find the exact moment you're looking for by hovering over the timeline and seeing a preview of each frame as you move along. Feedback is at the heart of Frame.io, which is why we've completely reimagined our commenting experience in version 4 to make collaboration simple, focused, and fun. To see these updates in action, let's jump into this new cut of a teaser trailer that my team wants my thoughts on. In version 4, you can share feedback down to the pixel with the new anchored comments. In this case, I want to tag my colorist and let her know that this particular area of the shot is a little hard to see. Gone are the days of writing a full paragraph just to get that point across. I can simply tap anywhere on the video to leave a comment directly on the asset itself. Anchored comments are really easy to find for new users, which is helpful for reviewers who might be unfamiliar with the concept of timestamped comments. They work on images and PDFs too. Another way we've reimagined commenting in version 4 is through comment attachments. This is a great way to move the conversation forward with some additional context. I have a few reference shots that I think could help my colorist understand the type of look we're going for here. I can drop these directly in the comment I'm writing so she can refer back to them when she makes her tweaks. I'll also add a hashtag to make this comment easier to reference back to later. Comment hashtags are always indexed, which means the next time I use hashtags, my previous ones will pop up as a suggestion. And here you can see another improvement in action, a keyboard-only commenting experience. When I submit this comment, my focus immediately shifts back to the player so I can keep using my keyboard to control playback. If I start typing again, the player is immediately paused so that I can finish my comment without missing any detail. These might be subtle improvements to the player experience, but they keep your efficiency top of mind and make sure you never miss a beat. And when words and attachments just aren't enough to express your thoughts, a simple emoji might do the trick. Reacting to comments with an emoji is a quick and fun new way to respond to feedback from your collaborators. Looks like my colorist is already on it. Feedback happens fast, and it's easy to miss critical comments amid the barrage of messages coming in on your work. That's why we've introduced comment filtering, which helps you find the exact conversation you need to see and respond to. You can filter by annotations, attachments, reactions, and more to quickly narrow down a long list of comments. And in version 4, there's a specific link to every comment so you can direct someone to a specific conversation. Our reimagined player experience lets your assets and conversations take center stage. We can't wait to see what you make with them.